So next we're going to look at separable first order ordinary differential equations, okay? So the whole idea, and honestly, I don't even know why we talk about these separately, because it's basically just keep doing what you've always been doing with ODEs, except, you know, now you have to integrate both sides of the equation. So basically the idea is it's separable if you can write it as something like some function of y times y prime equals gx. And the reason that we care is because I can write the dy as dy dx equals gx, and then I can just put the dx on the other side if I hand wave through some like hardcore calculus that only theorists care about, and I go like this. Yay! Okay, so anyway, the whole idea is you get something that is actually separable. You put all the y's on one side, you put all the x's on the other side, and you just integrate. It's super straightforward, it's super fun, it takes, you know, effort, because you have to know calculus. But aside from that, if you know calculus, you should be in good shape. All right, so let's give you an example. So say we have something like y prime is equal to x times, that's a horrible x, x times 1 plus y squared, like that. Woohoo! And you're like, yay, this is great, because it's separable. Because I can put the 1 plus y squared over here, and I've got dy dx. I'm already know I'm going to move the dy to the other side. So there's the, I'm sorry, move the dx to the other side. So there you go. Bam! Nothing doing. All right, choo-choo, choo-choo. Integrate, integrate. Oh, stupid integration. This is where I get sad. Because unless I have a fabulous table of integrals there, I'm kind of stuck. So I'm pretty sure it's something. And, you know, it's like, it reminds me of a tangent. And I think it's inverse tangent, but I'm not sure. But I need to be sure, because I don't even think that I could, like, no, I couldn't even use sub, because if I try to use sub, I'll do this, and then I'll have a du is equal to 2y, dy, and I don't have a y on top, so I can't do that. All right, but I think it's tangent, some kind of tangent. Let's prove it, because this is what we do for funsies. So we do an inverse tangent. So let's try going to base principles. The tangent of the inverse tangent of x has to be equal to x, right? Because that's how basic math works. Well, not basic math, but, you know, like fun math. The good kind of math that we do at parties. This is my favorite party trick, guys. Invite me to your parties and I'll do math on tablecloths. It'll be amazing. Okay, so if I ddx the whole thing, all right, I know that the derivative of tangent is secant tangent. So secant, this thing, tangent, this thing, secant, tangent, times the derivative of the inside, but that's a thing that I don't know, like that, and then the derivative of x is 1. Okay, so make sure that makes sense. I'm taking the derivative, I'm chain ruling it, the derivative of tangent is secant tangent, and I have to do the inside, then times the derivative. So this is the thing I'm trying to solve for, so I can just leave that the way it is. Now, the secant of the inverse tangent of blah, I don't know what this is, but I'll leave it for a second. Luckily, I know that the tangent of the tangent of that, you know what? I'm an idiot. Whatever the tangent is secant tangent, why didn't you say something? I knew I was going to get the wrong answer. Whatever the tangent is secant squared. How can we even say nothing? You're just like, I'm going to let you be stupid. Okay, there. I don't know what that is. That's a whole point. All right. Now you have no faith in me anymore because I can't do basic math like the derivative of the tangent. Okay, but that's okay because this is going to be cool anyway, so shut up. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to let this thingy theta be equal to the inverse tangent of x. Okay, so that means that the tangent of theta is equal to x. Now if you remember anything about tangent, besides the fact that its derivative is not secant tangent, you'll know that the tangent is equal to x, but that's also opposite over adjacent. So I could very well say my opposite is equal to x, and my adjacent is equal to 1. I promise you did this at some point in probably calculus 2, and you're like, this is stupid, I'm never going to use this again until I'm watching this stupid YouTube video. So I do that, and so that means the opposite of x, so I'll just draw my fake triangle here. So opposite is x, adjacent is 1, and that means that this side is 1 plus x squared, square root of 1 plus x squared, which is great, because if I'm trying to find the secant of theta, secant is the opposite of cosine, or the, not the inverse of cosine, but the, well, technically, it's the 1 over of cosine. So instead of being opposite or adjacent over hypotenuse, it's adjacent under a hypotenuse. So that's the hypotenuse is the square root of 1 plus x squared, and the adjacent is still 1, so secant theta is equal to square root of 1 plus x squared, and secant squared, that's why that other thing I'm not doing, is this thing, like that. Alright, so this was just theta, remember? So secant squared of tangent inverse of x is 1 plus x squared times the ddx of tangent of x. You're like, I really don't care. But you should care, because this is kind of fun. And you got to make fun of me a minute ago, because I couldn't remember the derivative of tangent. Like this equals 1 over this. So look, you did stuff. Okay, so now I have proven to myself that the integral of 1 over 1 plus x squared is, in fact, inverse tangent. And now all the boys will like me, because that's the whole reason we go into math. No, I'm totally kidding. That's not why I do math. I do math because it makes me happy. Math makes me happy. Do-do-do-do-do. Okay, like that? Beautiful? Amazing. Okay. Alright, okay, so the next thing I want to do is I want to say that y is equal to the tangent of 1 half x squared plus c and that's my answer. Yay! All done. Okay, that was fantastic. All right, so I'm going to give you a couple more in a follow-up video so you can just work through some of them. This one kind of is dragging on a little bit, but you'll get some more practice. But this is just kind of a basic introduction, is whenever you're working with separable, if you can get everything on one side that's y's and everything on the other side that's x, you work through it, and you'll get something nice and pretty. Have fun!